Hey everyone, welcome back. My name is Tobi and today I'm going to show you how to work with the different modules in our canAnalyser V3 standard. What's really comfortable when working with the various modules is the huge flexibility they provide. You can open the modules several times in parallel, arrange them as you want and store all these settings. So you can create your personal working environment as every project is different and requires special settings. If you are new to working with the canAnalyser, it might be useful to watch our other videos which describe the installation and the first steps when working with canAnalyser. I will put you the links in the description below. In this video, we will cover the different function modules: transmit, receive, sequencer, trace, and replay, and their configurations. We also show the message interpretation within the CANopen and the J1939 modules, which enormously simplifies the work with higher protocols, as all received messages are clearly displayed according to the protocol specification. So, let's get right into it. We have already opened the canAnalyser software and attached a USB to CAN V2 professional device. This device has two CAN channels. The CAN controllers have also been configured previously, so we can now add function modules. First, we will add a transmit module to CAN channel 1 and receive module to CAN channel 2. You can do so by dragging the modules from the left-hand side using drag and drop onto the different channels. Two new different windows will be created and opened automatically. Let's start with setting up the transmit module for CAN channel 1. You can manually enter messages with identifier, description, and data. For demonstration purposes, we will work with some dummy data. First, we enter identifier 1 and some dummy data. If you hover your mouse cursor over the different elements, you will see a short description about the meaning of the different text fields and checkboxes. Under cyclic options, we will insert 1000 milliseconds as the delay between the messages when using cyclic transmission. By clicking on the Insert a new message icon, we create a second message. We will fill in ID 100, some data, and a cyclic delay time of 100 milliseconds. There are many more options you can choose from, but for our sample, we like to keep it simple. Now we have set up the messages that we want to send. If we have not already done so, we have to start the CAN communication with the control panel by clicking on the green hook. To start transmission, we can either click on the TX symbol of each message line, which sends out the message once, or we can start cyclic transmission by clicking on the cyclic transmit icon. By clicking on the icon with CTRL key pressed, all defined cyclic transmissions will be started in parallel. Now, switching over to the message receive window, we can see the messages received in scroll view, a list where new messages are added at the end, and in override view, where you see the messages sorted by identifier. In override mode, you only see the last received messages for each individual identifier and a message counter in front. You can also filter messages, so you only see relevant information. To do so, you first have to define filters. This can be done by clicking on the filter icon, either in the receive module or in another module. Once defined, filters can be selected and used in many different modules. We now click on the filter icon and define a filter type in the category field. Let us use an ID range filter to show the feature. We define filter ID 100 as name and click on Add. Within the IE Express selection, we enter minus 100 and click on OK. This filter has now been defined and can be selected within the filter drop-down menu. After selecting this, all messages with ID 100 are filtered. There are many more filter options and possibilities available Just use the canAnalyser online help and search for handling of filters to learn more. So, those are the most basic features of the transmit and receive module, but you can do a lot more with our canAnalyser. Next, we will show you how to work with the sequencer module. We start the sequencer module and open a small sample project. As you can see, the message sequence is entered line by line, and for control, an easy to use set of commands is available. In our sample, we define that the sequence is repeated 100 times. Then we enter the messages to be sent line by line. TD stands for transmit data. Other commands include delay in milliseconds or pause, where the sequence waits for user action. When we are ready to start, we can click on the Start Sequence button to run the program. If you want to test the script step by step, there's also a single step mode available. Since it's easy to operate, the sequencer module is ideal for creating test or configuration routines. Okay, now let's have a look at the trace module. If you need to record messages over a longer time period, for example to analyze sporadic errors, or if you like to analyze data offline in detail, then the trace module is the right tool for you. The trace module is divided in two fields. At the top, you can define the settings for the recording, and at the bottom, you will see the recorded messages. So let us show you a quick and easy sample. For recording, we select the first CAN channel and define some basic settings. We define a filter, the one we created before. We set a start trigger. Here we can choose between error message triggers, ID and data triggers, or message count triggers. Let's take the last one and enter 100 messages. As a stop trigger, we can also select message count triggers and enter 20 messages. Pre-trigger would allow us to record messages before the start trigger event and is ideal when you trigger on errors and like to see the message before. But we will keep it as it is for now and start recording. To generate messages, we use the transmit module with the previously defined configuration. After 100 messages, the trace module starts to record the traffic and stops automatically after 20 messages. Since we filtered ID 100, this message is not recorded and the trace only contains the remaining unfiltered messages. As you can imagine, by using complex filters, pre-trigger and start-stop triggers, the trace module can be a very powerful tool for detecting sporadic errors or to analyze specific bus traffic information. For transmission of the recorded messages, the replay module is available. It allows you to load the trace file to resend messages either step by step or in message groups with predefined group size. Messages can be sent in original speed, full speed, or with defined delay times. That's all about message recording and replay. Let us have a look at the higher layer protocol interpretation for CANopen and SAE J1939. Using the CANopen module, all messages on the CAN bus can be displayed according to the CANopen notation. So let's use the sequencer to generate CANopen specific traffic on the bus. For this, I have prepared a special CANopen sequencer file. As you can see here, the CANopen module shows the received data and CANopen notification. On the left, we can select or deselect specific nodes in case we want to concentrate on specific devices. The menu at the top allows us to change the color for the various CANopen message types. We can also show raw data, and there are many more settings available. For the SAE J1939 module, we prepared a sequencer file to show you the interpreted data. As you see, the functionality behind this is similar to the CANopen module. But in this case, all messages are interpreted according to the SAE J1993 notification. I hope this video helped you to understand how to work with the various modules. In our next video, we will get more into detail about working with signals and DIM database. As always, you will find the links in the description below. We hope you enjoyed this video. So thanks for watching, and if you liked the content, please leave us a like and follow our channel. And if you have any questions regarding these topics, just leave a comment too. Until next time, bye bye.